Good evening, I'm Jody Leung in for Sean Ching.
And I'm Paula Akana. The University of Hawaii football team reached one of its goals Friday night by clinching the outright WAC championship. But one regular season game remains for an undefeated season and a possible big payday.
KITV sports director Robert Kekaula was at the coach's weekly press conference today. Robert, what did he say?
Well, coach talked about coming off the biggest game in school history, could even say the biggest game in the history of the WAC. Warriors are now preparing for the biggest game in school history. Again, UH hosts 4-8 Washington Saturday with a berth and a BCS game on the line. Critics say Hawaii's gotten one of the weakest schedules in the country, opposite for the Huskies. They've played one of the toughest, USC, Cal. They even beat Boise State. Common question over the weekend, should we as fans be concerned about a possible letdown by the Warriors after locking up the conference crown? Today I asked June Jones that question.
Is there any concern at all that your guys won't be ready and know how big this game is?
No. I could tell it already in the meeting today that everybody understands. If we don't win the game, it's not going to be because we're not ready to play, I can tell you that.
After watching game film over the weekend, coach especially happy how physical his defense played. Also happy how physical his offensive line played in the fourth quarter, running the ball to put the game on ice. Much more. We'll talk to a couple of players who were honored by the conference later in sports.
All right. Thanks a lot, Robert.
Yep.
Well, Aloha Stadium officials say they're pleased and they've gotten good feedback about how things went at the game on Friday. There was concern about security with allegations that some visiting fans have not been shown Aloha at Aloha Stadium. For the game on Friday, the Honolulu Police Department brought in a rapid response team of 75 officers, along with special duty officers. The stadium had extra security guards as well. Stadium officials say 10 people were ejected from the game, but that's normal. And now they're looking ahead to the Washington game this Saturday.
We're going to have an evaluation meeting tomorrow and see what we can't do better. But hopefully everything will stay in place and we'll make some minor adjustments in some areas that maybe we need to. But for the most part, everything will probably remain the same.
Now, they cut off beer sales early on Friday. No beer was sold after halftime. The parking and security measures will be pretty much the same for this Saturday's game.
During Friday's broadcast of the Hawaii-Boise State game on ESPN2, the announcers criticized the University of Hawaii's athletic facilities. KITV's Dan Meisenzahl has this story.
Our outright WAC champions.
In the closing seconds of the big game, after head coach June Jones got his Gatorade shower, in what was about to be one of the greatest victories in the history of University of Hawaii athletics, ESPN announcer Sean McDonough said this.
If you saw their practice field and their office buildings, you'd be amazed that they could have this kind of success with their facilities in, quite frankly, an embarrassing state of disrepair.
Harsh words heard across the nation.
It's not anything that isn't known.
At today's weekly press conference, Jones says his players aren't coming to UH for the facilities.
They come here because it's a great place to live and a great place to play football. And if we were recruiting to facilities, we wouldn't get anybody, you know. Those are the same dorms I lived in 1973.
Just this past May, quarterback Colt Brennan made headlines making similar statements. So what's the answer? A berth to a BCS bowl game and its multi-million dollar payout would be a good start.
If you get to the big dance, you know, it's going to help because you get the athletic department get some money. Hopefully that means Cook Field will get some field turf.
The UH Athletic Department says Athletic Director Herman Frazier would not be available to talk about the issue until his weekly press conference tomorrow. And everyone continues to make do, including the current players, whose responsibilities include giving tours to possible recruits.
You can't hide it, you know, but we try to, you know, take them outside of facilities, you know, take them to Waikiki Beach, you know.
Dan Meisenzahl, KITV 4 Island Television News.
There is no stopping the warrior mania now. The state health department released these numbers on baby names today. In 2007, 6 babies were named Colt, 13 Colton, and 18 Brennans. Compare that to 2006, when there were 4 baby Colts, only 6 Coltons, and only 12 Brennans.
You know the team is very successful when we're starting to reach for
good
the
yeah. Colt.
Like that.
And speaking of our own Colt Fujioka, gorgeous day today.
For the fourth time this season, UH quarterback Colt Brennan named WAC Offensive Player of the Week today. Quote, threw for 495 yards and 5 touchdowns. Also ran one in, leading the Warriors to a 39-27 win over Boise State back on Friday night, naming Hawaii's first ever outright WAC championship. How much time did you guys party, and when does the party stop and get ready for the next one?
You know what, to be honest with you, the party was that game. You know, I mean, that was what was awesome. You know, I went out after I got some food after the game, and then all of a sudden I hit the wall and I had to go to bed.
I hope you're all having a pleasant evening. And for the third time this season, Hawaii linebacker Solomon Elomimian named WAC Defensive Player of the Week. He recorded 14 tackles against the Broncos. UH ranked 12th by the BCS, 11th by AP, 10th in the coaches' poll. Washington's next. A win could propel the Warriors into a big payday bowl game.
Amongst the team today, what's the talk about yesterday's rankings?
Yeah, it feels good, you know, starting getting some, you know, recognition. But same time, it's like we don't want to be, you know, having a big party and then next, you know, this week lose to Washington. That's going to be embarrassing, you know. That's just going to prove everybody right. We were happy, but same time, you know, we just know that it could be gone, you know, in a second. So we just got to stay focused and just keep going for the goal.
Players and coaches alike love the Hawaii home crowd Friday. Going to need it again, they say, for the Huskies game.
Crowd was into the game, and hopefully they'll be into the game again this week, because it's very, you know, obviously helpful to the players to have that kind of crowd. It changes the momentum of different times of the game.
Everyone I know is saying, you know, BCS, who might we play? And, you know, if everybody really wants that to be a reality, all the fans out there, then they need to really focus on Washington, because unless we get through this week's game, there's no chance of that ever happening. And Washington is a good football team. So we have another war, you know, this Saturday, and we're going to need, you know, another great performance by everybody, fans, players included. And so we get that win, and then we can really have some fun.
Saturday's game versus Washington is sold out, and kickoff's a half hour later at 6:30.